Hello everyone, this is block-luban. Welcome to our channel. I'm Cathy, nice to meet you. Are you a user of Antminer 17 series? Are you troubled by the heatsink problems? Are they short-circuited? Are they falling off? Do you know why? Let me tell you why and how to deal with them. Let's go. Now, let's take the T17 heatsinks and see why they've got this problem. All right, so here, this is the heatsink. This is the chip, right? So the soldering material connecting them is tin, and this kind of tin has a relatively low melting point at about 138 degrees. And when the miner is running, the temperature goes up, and when it reaches at about like 80 or 90 degrees, the tin is in a semi-melted situation. If at this time the miner is overheated or power suddenly just shut down, the heat inside cannot be discharged, soldering joints will melt due to gravity, the heatsinks will just fall off. Another thing is, due to the low ductility and brittleness of tin, the heatsinks often fall off during transportation. For example, if I'm just like this, I just took one off. They fall off so easily. When they fall off, they also damage the chips. And as you can see, the chips are in serious connection. When one is broken, the whole hashboard doesn't work. That's why so many people need to upgrade their T17 series. So how do we do it? Let me show you. All right, so let's take a look at what tools do we need. All right, so here I've got board washing water, tweezers, the heatsink, of course, the nuts, and this is for sanding, and this is the silicone grease. Here are some screws, nuts and insulating pad, sanding tool. Here is the heat gun. So how to do it? Here I've got a T17 here, and let me show you. This is the board washing water. I'm gonna push a little bit and then wash it up. Clean the whole board. All right, now it is all cleaned up and I'm going to put this mold on and weld the nuts on it. Set up, and here's the heatsink, right? I'm going to put it right there. All right, now this one is done upgrading. Let's compare it with the original one. This is the original one. It is all flat, it's level, but for this one, after upgrading, the front side is a slope and the gap between the teeth is larger, which allows more air to come in to cool. On the rear side, the density increases, thus increases the dissipation surface, and the efficiency is 20% higher than regular heatsink. And after the upgrading, the dissipation efficiency is just as before, but damage that caused by transportation or power shutdown is reduced by 90%. Voila, it's done. Isn't it easy? If you have the tools and you just follow the tutorial carefully, you can do it by yourself.